ke bila? Untuk script, di sinilah permasalahannya. Jadi, ramai, ada juga yang ramai bertanya saya bagaimana proses penerjemahan itu berlaku. Bukan, basically dalam Ubuntu, kalau dilihat di mana-mana syarikat ataupun di mana-mana komunitas ke begitu kan, bukan semua orang mampu lakukan terjemahan. Ada orang faham bahasa Indonesia tapi mau diterjemah bahasa Inggeris ralat. Pening, apa ayahnya? Sama juga dengan bila kami macam orang Malaysia mau ngobrol bahasa Indonesia, apa ayahnya? Seperti contoh ada kawan saya, dia sedikit rusing dengan perkataan ban. Di sini bannya tayar. Tayar. Tapi di Malaysia bannya roti. Nampak? Di situ perbedaannya. Jadi it can be a bit confusing. So that is actually the important part bila mahu melakukan terjemahan. Jadi simple je, saya mau tunjuk sedikit basically sedikit lah. Ya, mau tu kat sini. Okey, jadi sebabkan session saya sedikit pendek, saya akan tunjukkan bagaimana proses terjemahan itu berlangsung. So jadi kalau bisa lihat di bolehlah lihat. Okey, jadi kalau di dalam untuk Ubuntu komunitas-komunitas sumber terbuka, kami mereka ada some sort of like open kind of way to send your translation. Maksudnya jika contoh mungkin kalau macam saya untuk nak mau bantu translate bahasa Indonesia, saya bisa lakukan. Tapi ada masa bukan semua perkataannya macam tadi permasalahan tadi kan. Bukan semua perkataan dalam bahasa Malaysia mirip bahasa Indonesia. Jadi di sini saya akan tunjukkan bagaimana proses-proses untuk lakukan apa nak itu proses translasi. So pertama sekali kita akan pergi ke laman ini. Saya buka barulah senang. Saya buka dulu. So launchpad.net. So launchpad.net ini adalah laman di mana kebanyakan perisian-perisian Ubuntu disimpan dan menjadi repository. Jadi boleh bisa download, bisa kalau ada masalah bisa direport di sini, bisa apa lagi kita membuatnya. Sebenarnya memang kira kalau untuk Ubuntu is all in one in here. Everything is happening here. Even the staff also using the same system. Okay. Jadi bagaimana untuk kita melakukan proses terjemahan itu. So sebagai contoh, saya akan pergi ke Ubuntu launchpad. So this is kalau dilihat ni launchpad.net/ubuntu. Jadi slash di kalau dilihat sini, di sini panggil apa ya? Pelang ya? Slash.
Slash.
Dari sini. Dari sini. Dari sini. Lihat, saya pun tidak tahu.
Dari sini.
Dari sini. Garis miring Ubuntu. So di belakang ini kebiasaannya adalah the name of the project. It's either depending. Sometimes it can be if I think your project, the project keep name, for example Firefox. They seperti I talk about Firefox, but another way on how they want to submit or collecting their repository. So jadi repository untuk Ubuntu menggunakan launchpad. Jadi di launchpad, jika dilihat di sini ada satu translation part. Di sini adalah tempat di mana proses terjemahan berlaku. Jadi sebagai contoh, nombor satu anda harus berdata. Harus berdata di laman launchpad ini. Okey, jadi di sini ini adalah ini adalah saya punya launchpad profile saya. So boleh dilihatlah di sini apa yang telah saya lakukan dari dalam repository mana saya ada berkhidmat dan juga membership. Okey. Jadi untuk for submitting the translation, first you have to go to this translation tab di sini. Jadi bila klik orang Malaysia pasti ya klik. So ya it will list out translation that has been done. So if you can see the lower part here, So this is for the next release 2310. So right now the release, the current release is 2304. So right now they are focusing on the next editor version. So kalau dilihat sini nampak. Sebab kenapa nampak dua saja? Sebab di dalam pilihan saya di sini, jika dilihat, I only choose two type of reviews je. Masa saya buat tetapan lah, when I'm setting for my profile. So I only specify, I only speak English and Malay. Alright, that's why on this page I can only see two languages. But if we go here, view all languages. If you click here, see, there's a lot of languages. So it's not just specific for Malays. As you can see, you can either actually, if I'm not mistaken, Java also got translation here. Are they still? Yep. See. So you can, if you speak Japanese, you want to submit your translation for Japanese people, you can do it. Alright. So let's focus on, for example, we go to Indonesian. So as you can see here, this is Indonesian. So it's probably can kind of like almost half of the whole ecosystem. So if you can see here, like for example, the one that most active, I think here, yeah, the German. The German. Jerman. Yeah. So probably yeah. If you went to German, if you ever went to Germany, you know that people there are hardly speaking English. So that's why they need software that really gimana ya, harus asli dengan negara mereka. Jadi as you can see, this is the percentage. So if for you guys Indonesian, you want to submit translation and also you want to allow orang-orang macam anak-anak muda ataupun orang-orang tua menggunakan Ubuntu lebih mudah, jadi disarankan untuk apa je, what's the word, to help submitting the translation. So here, if you are Indonesian enough, I'm not Indonesian enough, so you can just click here. So in my case, because I usually translate in Malay, so I go back to my original languages. Where is it? MMHIJKLM. Alright, so this is my language. So here, there's another progress bar inside the language itself. So this is actually focusing on the module inside Ubuntu. So like it's part. This one, you have to focus on which part you want to do translation. Actually, I think in Ubuntu, you have no requirement to do 100% than the languages you load in the OS. No, as long you put the translation, it will be in the system. So my suggestion is, kena harus pastikan modul-modul mana yang perlu kalian lihatlah. So jika dilihat di sini sebagai for example, where is it? Where is the most easier that I can share with you guys? Okay, so for example, inside Ubuntu, there's a Genome Minds game. I don't think I install inside here, but Genome Minds. Yeah, I don't install the Genome Minds. So actually, there's a game called Minds inside Genome. So if I click here, see, alright. So this is all the translation pages. As you guys, if I go through one by one here, so this is. Okay, alright, so just focus on this part. Here, from here to here. Okay, there's a very small line here. Okay, alright, jadi di sini bahasa asalnya, bahasa Inggris. This is on the system. So, currently, someone already submitted di translation for jelung mice, which is periuk api. Di sini saya tidak dalam kalau mice di sini apa ya bahasa Inggris, bahasa Melayu, bahasa Indonesia nya
ranjau.
Ranjau. Jadi ranjau jelung. Bisa di sini saya. Jadi di sini adalah untuk bahasa Melayu nya, bahasa Malaysia nya. So bagaimana kalau saya rasa macam tidak enak bunyi periuk api? Mungkin ada terjemahan yang lebih enak atau perlu lebih hampir. Jadi di sini anda bisa cadangkan. Ya, di sini ada kotak sini new translation. So ini adalah cadangan yang mungkin lebih sesuai ataupun lebih mirip yang rasanya lebih hampir dengan periuk api. Sebagai contoh, saya turunkan bawah ni. Saya turun sikit bawah. I go bit down. Where is it? Okay, so for example here, you can see there's a small board, medium board, and so big board. Okay. Alright, so if looking here, if you think papan kecil is this is okay, not your language, but for example, if this translation is okay, then you leave it. But if you think the translation is not that kind of like not that accurate enough, you can edit it just by clicking here, the new translation, and you just put it inside here. Oh yeah, you just put it the new one. But if you kind of like 50-50, you feel like this translation is, I don't know, is it accurate enough or someone can suggest it more better, you can click down here. So if you are sending the new translation, someone other than you will be reviewing it first. So if they think it's okay, then it will be submitted to the repository. Sebagai contoh yang boleh saya bagi di sini, kalau di screen saver apa ya maksudnya bahasa Indonesia?
Penangkap
layar kan?
Screen saver.
Yang luar, luar yang bagi animasi kalau itu. Apa ya? Apa ini sebenarnya? Kita tahu tak apa ya? Tak saya itu lah. Kalau bahasa Malaysia nya, kalau di terjemahkan terus langsung diterjemahkan, jadi penyamaran aja. Tapi apa yang diselamatkan? Jadi translasi apanya terjemahan untuk bahasa Melayu for screen saver adalah apa ya? Bukan penyelamat. Something like that. Let me try to search the word. Apa ya? Screen saver. Oh, sorry. Ya. Gambar screen. Jadi bahasa Melayu. Nampak tak nampak kan? Tapi sebenarnya sebab itu tak logik sebab itu pada anda semua orang Indonesia mungkin bunyinya apa gambar sih?
Besar.
Sebenarnya
itu masih gambar.
Ya,
kan
masih gambar kan? Gambar sih. Jadi pada orang Malaysia benda kalau kita jemahkan sebagai penyelamat screen, apa yang diselamatkan? Adakah dia sepenyu? So jadi lebih yang jadi untuk terjemahan begini, yang lebih hampir atau lebih mirip adalah gambar screen. Sebab kebiasaannya kalau screen saver keluar gambar. Logiknya di situ. Tapi kalau difikirkan secara orang kalau orang IT, misalnya kalau untuk somebody that background IT, there's no logic. Apa itu gambar screen? But for the languages, for someone I think Indonesian also are very proud with your language. So there's a body that I'm guessing standardizing all your languages. So they are the one who are much more familiar with type of the words and also the what is it called, the lingo that goes around. Misalnya seperti contoh scrolling, tahu pernah dengar scrolling? Bahasa Indonesia
kulir.
Bahasa Melayu ya,
tatal.
Tatal. TATAL. Mentatal. Ya, tatal.
Kalau bahasa Sunda itu tatal.
Ya, tatal. Ya, hampir.
With R, with R.
Benar-benar. Tak. Okey, sebab perbuatannya tolak. Tatal bahasa tatal kalau Sundanya mana apa terjemahannya?
Di.
Dibesarkan.
Mentatal.
Ya, mentatal.
Tatal.
Jadi kalau buat perbuatannya, kalau ini saya cerita suara saya lebih pasti bahasa Melayu. Saya tak pasti bahasa Melayu. Maaflah. Jadi saya cuma terangkan daripada saya cuma mampu terangkan daripada aspek bahasa saya. Jadi kalau bahasa saya mentata adalah perbuatannya tolak ataupun
membuka ya.
Ya, membuka.
Yeah, it's nothing so
so. Yeah. So scrolling.
Yeah.
You can membuka. Nampak? Logik pada orang IT, kalau itu kawan saya tu lagi tak tahu apa tatal. For IT people, there's no logical. Why tatal? There's another word you can use. But for the languages, the one that expert in language thinks that tatal is the most accurate because it's more close to the origin of the word. Yes. So. Translation can be a bit controversial also. So it's best to do it in work. To best do in group. And also from Malaysian team, we also got we have a panel that managing our translation. And that panel is also being dibantu oleh kalau di Malaysia ada satu badan yang menjaga bahasa kami, itu Dewan Bahasa dan Pustaka, DBP. Malaysianya sebutnya DBP tapi kalau di sini DPP. Jadi Dewan Bahasa dan Pustaka adalah badan kerajaan yang bertanggungjawab menjaga bahasa Malaysia, bahasa kami. Jadi mereka juga akan bersama-sama dengan translation team kami untuk pastikan adakah terjemahan itu mirip hampir dengan bahasa yang ialah bahasa Melayu asal, bahasa Melayu aslinya. Jadi begitulah lain terjemahan yang pada saya saya rasa kalau saya ceritakan pun mungkin tak logik, tapi bila sudah dipahami daripada aspek bahasa ada benarnya. Sebagai contoh what is it? Selfie. Tahu selfie. Gambar selfie. Selfie. Ya, selfie. Ambil gambar. Suap foto. Ya. Kalau di Malaysia juga mereka suap foto juga. Suap foto. Tapi logiknya apa yang suap foto? Jadi daripada bila orang yang apa ni, I call it professional. Bila orang profesional itu menerangkan apa itu suap foto, suap is mean us. Self. Saya pun tak tahu suar itu adalah perkataan untuk diri sendiri ataupun sendiri. So suar foto, ambil gambar sendiri. Daripada kalau ambil selfie for English, selfie is self. Selfie. But for Malay, I think the most jargon, the common word probably ambil gambar sendiri. That's four words. Ambil gambar sendiri. Three words, which is nonsense. But then for the linguist, they think suap foto is the most closest one and most logical one. That's why it's important to if you guys can work with linguists, it's much more accurate. Alright, so okay, I'm going back to this thing. So I think the one that I show is only online available. Jadi misalnya bagaimana kalau kalian semua pulang ke kantor, pulang balik kampung. Sini balik kampung ya?
Kampung
ya?
Ya.
Ada balik lebaran kan? Balik lebaran. Di sana mana ada internet? di mana membuka ini, atau mungkin balik kampung seminggu mau apa tuh menikmati udara segar daripada duduk di Jakarta penuh dengan macet. I've been to Jakarta 2 times. The traffic there
horrible.
I don't know. Anyone from Jakarta here? No. How do you get people there? It's nonsense.
It's not necessary.
Anyway, so biasanya kalau pulang ke kampung, obviously not everyone has internet back home. So but you still has some eager you want to submit because probably orang lama lebih boleh bantu, bisa bantu untuk melakukan terjemahan. Jadi bagaimana mau melakukan terjemahan ini secara offline? Jadi di sini, jika contoh sebagai contoh, saya fokus di sama juga di Genome Mind sini. Bisa buka. Ada satu option, ada satu pilihan yang you can download. See? Download the translation. So if you download here, it will download everything. So if you can see here, let me see. So this is 80 translation. So which means there's 80 boxes that you need to fill up here. So if you see, this is the information. This is the original word. This is your word. This is the translation word. So you want to translate this, but because you have got internet, how can you submit it? So this is the all offline way. So first, you just click download translation, and it will download all the 80 stream that you need to translate. So once you already click request download, so will it be alright? So here it will send request receive, accept receive email shortly. So it will email the link to your email, which is the one that you already registered in your launchpad. Okay, so wah bahaya ini buka emailnya. Mana emailnya? Mana? Oi, itu nggak boleh, nggak bisa. Jadi mungkin mengambil masa sikit sebab internetnya sedikit. The internet kind of bit slow.
These are everyday life.
Baik.
Dan is our everyday life like this.
Well, yeah, I cannot
complain. Buat apa?
Kena complain. So unfortunately, I haven't yet download the. Yeah. Is there any email here? Hello. Emailnya enggak mau ini. Ini yang bahaya ni. Jangan diambil. Let's see, is there anything here? No. Probably. I can't remember which folder I already put it into here. But yeah, is there anything? Yeah, internetnya perlahan, lambat.
Lambat sekali.
Yeah. So okay. So yeah, here. So this is the email, see? So this is from Launchpad. So you can see it will be given this link. So you can download by from this link, okay? So when I click here, The file must be in .po. Okay, see the ending file is in .po. So once I download it here, so take a while. Right. Okay. So now I already download the file. So here, PO genome, mice. Is it plus? Yeah, it's plus. So if it's dash. So if you are translating in Indonesia, it's probably in ID dash ID dot PO. So this PO file can be opened in external software. So let me show you. So here okay, I'm going to open my application. Where is it? POAD. P. Yeah, this one.
Hello, man.
Alright, so this is an offline way to submit your to do translation. So this one, if you want to do a project, if you want to open the file, so just click here and then open. So look at download. And then you go, see, there's a file that I've already downloaded. So once I double click it, there you go. So this is all the 80s translation that should be in this website, in this, where is it? This one, no, okay, this one. Okay, not email. Yes, this one, this translation, so if you can see, number one, genome mice, and if I go through the PO edit, yeah, where's the PO edit? Is it missing or not? Here, edit. See, jadi lihat ya. Di sini adalah asalnya, source. Di sini adalah terjemahannya. Okay. Jadi bagaimana mau membuat perubahan ataupun mau mengedit terjemahan tersebut? Boleh bisa lihat di bawah ini. Ia adalah source file. Just leave it as it is, but this one is the one that you need to focus on here, translation. So you can just put anything down here and you can save it. So once you save it, how to resubmit back to the repo? So let me show you this one also. So I just leave it as it is. Okay, so back to this screen. So once you already do, jika sudah lakukan terjemahan secara offline, bagaimana mau upload semula pergi ke repository. Jadi jika lihat di atas sini, if you see up here, there's an upload translation site. Okay, so just click here, right, and it will ask you which file to upload. So you can just click browse and you can look your file. Where is it? Which one?
Modified.
Modifiable.
Below.
You can?
Below.
Oh yeah, this one. Okay. So just double click it in browse and just click upload. So it will be synced based on terjemahan yang sudah dilakukan. So all the translation will be upload and either someone will review it or the, for example, if you submit it for the latest one, it will be applied to the next release. So depending on the situation, so you can just do it. But my suggestion is try to do it in group, so everyone can do bit by bit. For example, I don't believe everyone can do this all. So as you can see, so this is here. This is our submitter, you get it? So this is Abu
Yub, and then we got Hasbullah Bipi, we got who else? Yahya, Dekwan, this guy.
So try to make it. You can make sure focus on don't focus on everything. Just focus on smaller things first. For example. Probably on library part, this library give the lib one. This is the most important one. So the one that I show you, this one, the genome mice is just only for genome mice only. But for system wide,
Maksudnya kalau mau Ubuntu-nya itu nanti bahasa Indonesia-nya lebih jelas, lebih banyak penggunaannya, lebih banyak terjemahannya. Try to focus on the lib one, because the lib one, if you can see, there's a 200, there's 4,000 line you need to edit. It will take time, but try to pass the translation part by part. Probably someone focus the first 1,000 and then second guys focus the next 1,000. I don't think 1,000 is too much, because from my experience, I handled 2,000 lines in one day. Actually, it's just a simple line. As you can see, this is just, see? When I go to here, yeah, see? So the session is just this kind of 1, 2. So it's just it's not really that long, except for example, on this part probably take some time to translate. So you guys probably it's best to focus in the group, right? Okay. Berapa lama lagi saya ada masa? Kak, berapa lama? 10 minit. Oh, 10 minit lagi. Okay. Jadi rasanya begitu saja kalau untuk terjemahan di sini yang boleh saya tunjukkan. Okey. Jadi seperti di sini kalau dilihat, kalau ingin membantu, bukan jangan menganggap don't assume that this translation is for Ubuntu only. It's just treat it as you are helping your friends or maybe probably other Indonesian that are trying to use computer, because not everyone, like I said, in Malaysian perspective, not everyone is understand English. Not everyone can understand what is apply, what is copy, what is etc. So by doing translation, we might help those people that could not understand English to understand better when using computer. Okay, so overall, hopefully, if we scroll down here, I see the where is it? The Indonesian translation. Probably you guys can submit it and make it much more Indonesian. Like, yeah, because if I remember, there's a Indonesian one, Blangkon Linux dulu. Blangkon. Misalnya kalau saya ingat bahasa menggunakan bahasa Indonesia, benar. Jadi mungkin kita mungkin kalian semua tidak dapat membuat Blangkon, tapi mungkin ini boleh menjadi pengganti sebagai Blangkon, pengganti Blangkon Linux. Jadi orang Indonesia semua bisa menggunakan komputer, bisa celik IT. Kalau pada orang Malaysia, we are trying to make people understand computer, not understand to being technical, but just to use computer. Understand them to how to do some simple typing, some simple mouse. Because I have experience. People like I think most of us are 20s in 20s. They have no experience using computer. So they don't know how, they kind of afraid to move the cursor of the mouse. So it's best to make him IT literate person. Alright. Okay. Actually, let me. I think control. Alright. Okay. So like I said, translation. Anything, I think I'm guessing open source translation. I'm not focusing on other translation. Open source translation, either Ubuntu, GNOME, anything that regarding on open source. Even LibreOffice also, LibreOffice also has translation section. That I think the LibreOffice guy will appreciate if you can submit your translation so that everyone can use. So translation is basically it's not a technical stuff. So it can be whether being done by basic guy like the one I'm guessing keyboard guy also. You got feeling to do typing. So you guys are much more feel on what to type. So yeah. Everyone can do it, and it's not really that too technical, alright. But so this is one of the project that really benefit. This is one of this is an old project that I participate. This is back in what is it? See, 2004. This is back in 2010. So this project is taking is using exclusively Launchpad as a platform to do translation. So it's, if I'm not mistaken, it's been translated for more than 100 languages around the world. So yeah, as you can see, it's basically a manual. So I'm the one who translate for the Malay version of it. I didn't find the Indonesian because the name is there, but I haven't met the guy. I don't know how to see it, but later I can show it to you. So this is one the project that taking advantage on doing the translation part. So translation is not actually about just about language, just about IT, just about computer. For me, the translation itself is more about community. So it's the community side that people kind of like taking, I can say they haven't seen. Oh, what's it? So, community is one of the beauty in open source. So by translating it, automatically you are in the community. So yeah, this is one example that we doing. This is not technically. What is it called? A technical a meetup, but this is actually back in 2013, no, 2009. Ubuntu did a session called Translation Jam. Yeah, Translation Jam basically is a session where everyone contributing translation for Ubuntu. So this is the part of Ubuntu Jam. So this is the true gem of open source, the community itself. I mean, all of you guys here, you guys who use it, the one who submit it, the one who simply just share it to anyone, you are the community. So basically, yeah, this is one of our Malaysian community. So community is the true gem. And also, I also managed to. If you can see here, I think this is a kind of familiar faces for Ubuntu guys. Mark Shuttleworth, founder. I can say founder of Ubuntu itself. So we've also managed to. I also managed to meet with them. This is Genome committee, the Genome Foundation committee. So yeah, it's kind of like it's not just about us. It's not just about you guys Indonesian, but it's about all of us. I mean, even though I'm Malaysian, I cannot understand Indonesian, but once you guys is in our community, you are in our family. I mean, I've known Mas Yudi, Pak Yudi, those guys. They've been in our contact for a long time. So it's like a family, especially for us Indonesian and Malaysian. So I think this is the last note from my side. Oh, sorry. This is for Genome. Okay. So this is my friend. Actually, this is the middle one. So my friend actually is the one that bring me inside open source culture. So He share me these three mantra. Probably can, probably you guys can apply it in, not just in your activity, but probably in life. So this is what I've been holding since I embrace the open source. Alright. So first mantra is information is free. You have to know, but people are not. You have to pay. Still, contributor is priceless. You have to be. Right. So I think that's all. Thank you. Abu Hayyan, is there any question? Yeah.
Let's say
that
you are contributing to share file and share for to resolve the conflict.
Resolve the conflict. Okay. So for resolve the conflict, that's it. Okay. Kalau misalnya kalau menggunakan PO, for example, if you are using POAD, you have to specify which line they have to focus. That's I don't think there's another way. But for launchpad, let me go here. Alright. Like I said, if there's a conflict and you kind of like not sure atau tidak pasti sama ada terjemahan itu benar atau hampir atau tidak, bisa guna saja yang someone should review this thing. Ataupun jika rasakan memang terjemahan itu jauh langsung, tidak dekat, memang tidak hampir langsung dengan terjemahan asalnya, bisa aja pilih di sini tanpa pilih di sini. Jadi dia akan override, it will override the whole translation. But if you think the translation is like 50-50, like I said, you are not sure this translation is okay, is it close enough, is it correct, you can just hit over here. So someone can review it, and also you can if no one review it, it will update directly. Alright, I think it's already, yeah. Can I get one more question? Can? Is it? Okay, boleh? Boleh kah? Satu soalan, mau tanya? You can create an informal one, because if you, for example, Chinese got traditional, you got simplified. Chinese kan orang kan. So there's a lingo over there. So you can create an additional. For example, if you want to make a like I said, Indonesian is Indonesian, but you got Javanese, you got Sunda, you got what are this other kind of vibrance of language. You can request to add it, but you have just to make in mind, once you already make it, if you translate it alone, it will be hassle. So try to plan what kind of session you want to do. But commonly we use formal one. Okay, is it answering? All right. So I think that's all my session. So anything you guys can look me at the Kerenika booth. Anything? Yes, because Kerenika booth is quite empty. So yeah, thank you.